Russ Nelson from Red Carpet News. My question is to my favorite genius, Mr. Guillermo Del Toro. Picking up on what you said before, I'd like to ask why you think it is that right from our earliest fables, there has always been an inextricable link in our stories between love and...
Love and monsters. I made a movie that is one of my favorites, my four favorites I've done, that is not going to be the one that people will think of when they think about me. It's Crimson Peak. But I adore that movie. And it says, love makes monsters of us all. And in a strange way, I think that it's linked because I think you're never as certain and as afraid as you are when you fall in love. You know, the two things are overwhelming. And it's an emotion that is unique and healing. And I think that when you think about the only way we can express in words what we feel emotionally when you're in love is by singing. Telling someone you love that person more than anything in the world, you can say it over and over again and it doesn't reach. But if you sing, the emotion is, it gels. That's why in Mexico we serenade. But I think that visually and storytelling wise, the closest you can come to a song is a fable or a fairy tale, you know, because it destroys the barriers of the now and it makes it eternal. And you can address the larger truths and make them flesh without debasing them with peculiarities, you know? So I think that is in the, if you think about it, when I studied fairy tales intensely in 2004, 2006, I spent 2 years really trying to cipher them for Pan's Labyrinth. I found that there were about 30, 40 basic fables. One of them was the magic fish, which is a creature that emerges from the waters, concedes three wishes to a family, exposes their truths, and heals or destroys their life, you know, depending on the variation you read. And I thought, oh, that archetype is going to work, and then Beauty and the Beast is going to work. And you take those archetypes because they are so primal, we cannot explain them. You know, when you get to the seed of it all, there's something inherently human in using these instruments to explain who we are in the universe. So I don't know if that answered your question, but it sounded real good to me.